implement stack using arrays. See, we can implement stack using two methods, using arrays and using linked list. In this video, we will see how to implement stacks using arrays. Means we will use static memory allocation and we are going to implement all the operations of stack, right? So I guess everybody knows how to declare an array like this: data type, name of the array and size of the array, right? When you declare this array, it means in the memory 5 blocks have been allocated for this array. 5 blocks with how many bytes? 5 into for integer, how many bytes? For one integer, 4 bytes would be allocated, means 20 bytes. 20 bytes would be allocated, right? Index is 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4. Fine. Suppose address is 100. So next, this address, for this block, address is 104, because 4 bytes for one integer, right? Next 4 byte for this, right? So this is how you are going to represent array in memory. That thing we have already discussed. Now, if you write down this array like this, if you rotate this array like this, it means this is what? A stack. This is logical representation of stack. Fine. Same 5. Suppose I am taking size 5. So here I am taking int rather than a, I am taking name stack. You can take a, b, c as you wish, right? But we are implementing stack, that is why I am taking name stack, just for an understanding purpose. And size is, suppose I am taking 5, right? 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Same 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4, because using arrays I am going to implement this stack. Index would be started from 0. We are implementing this stack in C, right? So this is how we can declare the stack, right? Here we have fixed the size, that is for 5 elements I want the size in the memory. 5 into 4, 20 bytes would be allocated. And now suppose in future I want to insert 10 elements. In that case, what we can do, the simple rule of array is what? Another array would be allocated, maybe of size 50 or how much size you specify of that size, and all the element from the previous array would be copied there, and after that you can insert new element there, right? That is what the processor is, because this is what static memory allocation that we have discussed already when we were discussing array. Now we will see how to write down a program, how to implement push, pop and all operations of the stack, right? So now we are going to define here four functions: push, pop, peek, or you can say top, or display, or you can say traverse, right? And these function we will call in main function. Fine. You can use switch case statements for calling these function, means case 1, press 1 for push operation, case 2 may press 2 for pop, for press 3 for peek and press 4 for display. Like this you can implement switch case statement. I guess you can write down these function in switch case statement. I am going to implement these function here. Now I have declared here, see, in all the functions we are going to use what? This top variable, because from the top only we can insert, we can push and delete, or you can say pop element from the stack, right? So initially we initialize what? Top is equal to minus 1. Fine. And we are going to use this top in all the functions. That is why globally I am declaring this variable, right? And here I am taking int stack, the name is, the array is stack, and here the size is n. Fine. This is what I am declaring globally after header files, outside of all the functions, because inside any function or inside main function you cannot declare array something like this. You have to give here constant size, because outside, but outside you can declare like this. And now this n is what? You can give this n size using that macro definition, hash define n 5, or here you can write 50, 100, 500 as you wish, right? Means n value can be, here I am taking n value is 5. Or if you are not taking macro, then simply you can write int stack, here you can write size, that is 5. It's up to you, right? So now first of all we will define what? Push function. So now in push, obviously we are going to insert the data in the stack. So we will ask from the user which data he wants to insert. So using printf, I can take the value, printf enter data, right? And for storing this data, obviously you need some variable, right? Suppose I am taking x. So in this you have to declare that variable x, right? And suppose user has entered here 5. Now 5 I want to insert here. Now have to insert, see the capacity of this stack is what? 5 we have already declared, 0 1 2 3 4, 0 to 4, and top is initially -1. Top is -1. So how to push? First of all, you will increase the stop, after that you will put here, fine. But as well as we will check for the overflow condition. If the stack is full, in that case we cannot insert, we cannot push any data, fine. So here first of all what you will write, if, now suppose top is here, top is pointing to 4, means here I have 1 2 3 4 5 elements I have, in that case top would be pointing to 4. In that case we cannot insert any other data here. So what you will write in if this value, the top is equal to n minus 1. See here I am taking what? N. You can simply write, if you take directly here 5, so here you can write if top is equal to 4. Here n minus 1 means n is 5, 5 minus 1 that is 4, fine. So if top is 4, in that case here you can print overflow condition. You cannot insert, right? Else you will do what? Now first of all you will increase this top. First you will increase top ++, or you can say top is equal to top +1. After that you will insert the data. So here now top is equal to 0. Here now you will insert, see array name is, here I am taking stack, not A. Now stack of top is equal to x. Top value is 0, means stack of 0. Here I will insert x. Suppose x is 5, so here I will insert 5. Right? And that's it about this push operation. Or here if you will not ask the data here, if you want to pass the argument here, then here directly you can pass. Right? Push maybe 5 you can pass. Here you have to receive that value. So void here push, and here also you need to write down that int of any variable name like int x or int a, where you can receive this value, fine. And no need to ask, no need to write here printf and scanf, directly you can write down these statements, right? Here you can write down that variable name you have taken here, fine. So here second method is you can pass the value in the argument. So now we will define this function pop, right? Here I am writing this coding, I am writing void pop. We are not going to pass any argument in pop, that I have discussed already when we were discussing that theory part, that in pop always the top element would be popped out. So no need to pass any argument here, fine. Now if you want to print that value, that deleted value, suppose here the top is 5 only, I have only one element and I want to pop this and I want to print this value also, fine, that the popped item is 5, fine. So in that case what you will do, see, simply in the pop you will do what? Top -, as we have discussed in previous case. After that top -, means top becomes -1, and this is now the garbage value, no need to delete this value. Or if you want to print this value, in that case first of all you will take out this value, right, store this value in some another variable. After that you will do top -, and after that you can print that variable. Now what you will do, see, obviously for taking out this value and for storing this we will take another variable, that is suppose int item I am taking, fine. And you will also check for underflow condition. If there is no data in this stack, then you cannot pop anything, that is underflow condition. So what you will write, if top equal to -1, fine. If top is -1, then no data is there in the list. So here you will print simple underflow. In printf you can write underflow. Else first take out this value if you want to print that the popped item is this one. So first of all simply take out this value, store this in item. Item is equal to stack of top, right? Now stack of top means 5 has been stored in this item. Now you can do top -, right? And here you can print that the deleted, the popped item is %d and item. So like this, here you can printf, the popped item is percentage d, and here you can write item, and after that you can close the cells, and then this pop function, right? And if you don't want to print this popped item, then simply what you will do, no need to write down this line, simply do top minus minus, and no need to write down this line, fine. If top minus minus, top would be minus 1, that this value become garbage, and we don't care what garbage lies here, because after that when you will push any other data item, then this value would be overwritten, that is fine, right? So now this is push and pop operation. Now we will see what is peak operation. So as we have discussed in the previous video, what is this peak operation or the top operation? You can say top element means getting the topmost element of the stack without removing that element from the stack, right? Means without doing top minus minus. I just want to check out which is the topmost element of the stack, that's it, right? So here if you call this peak, it means it should return 5, but we will not do top minus minus. This 5 would still be in the stack. We just want to see which element is at the top of the stack, right? So how you will print that thing? So now if in the stack there is nothing, then the topmost element is, there is no element in the list, so it should print stack is empty. So how you will check? If top equal to minus 1, same thing, it means here you can print what? Printf stack is empty, right? Else you will print the top element. So here simply you will write printf, the topmost element is percentage d. After that, here the topmost element, how to print? Name, here I am taking stack, and here you will write in subscript top, the top element, right? In this case, top is now 0 because only one element is there, so 5 would be printed. And here we will not do top minus minus because we are not going to remove this from the stack. Now this is the peak function. Now we will display the content of the stack, or you can say we are going to traverse the stack, fine. Suppose we have called this push function 4 times and 5162. This is now the stack. These are elements in the stack. Fine. Now I am going to traverse the stack. I am going to display the content of the stack. So here first of all we will display 2, then 6, then 1, then 5. We are not popping out. We are just displaying the content. Or somewhere you also find out that they will start the loop from here only. They will display 5162. And somewhere you find out that they'll display 2, 6, 1, 5. It's up to you. Here I am going to display from the top of this one, because we can access from the top only, fine. So now we are going to start a for loop, obviously, right? For that we need a variable. Suppose I am taking here I, and here I am writing a for loop. I is equal to, I am starting from here, from the top. See, top is pointing to this after pushing 4 data, 4 elements. So I is equal to top, right? Till I greater than equal to 0, till here I want to print greater than equal to 0, right? And I minus minus, till then I am going to print the value, printf percentage d and stack I, right? Now you can traverse this thing. I is equal to top. Now I is equal to, in at this case top is equal to 3, so I is equal to 3. 3 is greater than equal to 0, yes. So control will enter into this loop, printf percentage d stack of I, stack of 3. In stack of 3 I have 2, so 2 would be printed, right? Again I minus minus, now I becomes 2. 2 is greater than equal to 0, condition is true, control will go enter into this loop, stack of 2 would be printed, stack of 2 is now 6, 6 would be printed. I minus minus, now I becomes 1, condition is true again. Now what would be printed? Stack of 1, stack of 1 is 1, 1 would be printed. Minus minus 0, 0 greater than equal to 0, condition is true again, enter into this loop, stack of 0 is 5, 5 would be printed. Now this is the output, 2, 6, 1 and 5, right? This is how we are going to traverse the list, traverse the stack. And these function you will write in switch case statement. I guess everybody can write down these thing in switch case statement. Case 1 means push, then break. Case 2 means pop, then break. Case 3 means peak, then break. Case 4 means display, then break. And in default case, you can write down invalid choice. And you can write down the switch case into do while loop. fine, and condition may be while choice not equal to 0. If 0 you will press 0, it means exit, right? See, this is how you can write down the main function using the switch case statement, right? Using do while loop, do and do while loop I am taking here, fine. Enter choice 1 for push, then 2 for pop, 3 for peek and 4 for display. I am taking a variable ch where I am taking the choice from the user. So, I am declaring that variable here, fine. This is for clearing the screen. Switch, here I will pass that choice. In case 1, I will call push. When you will press 1, then push should be called. And after that, you are using break. See, if you do not write this break, in that case, if you will press 1, then push should be called. After that, pop would be called, right? And if you will use this break, means only push function would be called, and after that break. Means again, it will ask to you for the another choice, right? That is why we are using here break. In case 2, we are calling pop, then break. In case 3, we are calling peak, then break. In case 4, we are calling display and then break. Default, suppose if you press 6, in that case, it should print some invalid message. I mean proper message. That is why I am taking here in default case, printf is equal to invalid choice. When you will enter 5, then it will print invalid choice, right? After that, closing this switch, and after that closing this do. While choice not equal to 0, it is what? 0, right? If you will press 0, means you are going to exit, fine, from the output screen, and then get CS. This is how we are going to write down that main function. I guess everybody know the syntax of switch case statement, fine. So this is how we are going to implement the stack using arrays. In next video, we will see how to implement stack using linked list, and all these operation push, pop and this peak operation, all these operation is going to take how much time? Order of 1, right? Because as you have seen in all the push, pop and peak operations, we haven't used any that for loop, fine. So that is why the time complexity is order of 1, fine. Maybe for searching or for displaying the content, it is order of n, fine. But for these operations, it is order of 1 only, fine. So now I'll see you in the next video. Till then, bye bye, take care.